Let's go! Alright. Welcome back to... oh, shoot. Sorry about that. Hang on. Ah! Okay, there we go. Okay. Welcome back to some daily Final Fantasy XIV, a.k.a. Legend of the Liger Dragon Heaven's Ward, Episode 31. My name is Rex Liger Kiddo, cyberpunk-loving, space-traveling... Pro wrestler, universal champion, and warrior of light. Oh my god. I am still not over what had happened in the last episode with... Oh my god, that Nidhogg battle, that was awesome. That was hype. Oh, but, sorry I couldn't, stream on the weekend. Yeah, I did get lazy. Like I said, if I don't get lazy, I was gonna stream... the raid battles, but luckily I didn't I was doing some stuff on the side. Like you can see, I have this little accompaniment node that we got from Wedge for doing a dungeon, and I was doing a couple of dungeons here, if I haven't noticed, probably. But yeah, I also did a couple raids. Yeah, I did a couple of raids. The Void Arc, which was the Sky Pirates storyline. I did all of it. It was fun, not gonna lie. Like, wow, I really like raids. I absolutely love raids. And also you can notice my attire. Hey, look at that boy. Look at it. How spiffy he looked. I absolutely learned how to use the glamours proper. I also got some casual gear, a sword, a bit of bullet. Look at that. Perfect. I even got a Santa hat. anyways, all right. Let's get to it, shall we? We also got a. Also got a couple. Let me put them in the glamour. That's fine. Sorry. Where is it? This one? No. Yeah, this one. And look at this. Yeah. Look at that. Oh my god. We got that with the Centurio steels that I got from my paladin. From my paladin armor. Oh my god, that looks nice. That looks clean. Anyways. Alright. Enough messing around. We're also back to being a paladin again. Oh my god. It's been such a while since I have been a paladin that I forgot how to play. So when I was doing the raids, I had no idea what the hell I was doing. But, yeah. Oh man. Oh man. Those raids were fun. I cannot wait to get to the Alexandria raid. Cause one of the people on the Discord from the free company that I'm in, told me that to try that out. That it's a whole lot of fun. So anyways. But before we do that, we gotta go and finish the rest of the post game. Cause we already finished the Dragon Song War. And now we're basically gonna be setting up for Storm's Blood, I think. Woo! I saw a thumbnail of the trailer for Storm's Blood. I'm excited cause it looks like we're going to Doma. Oh man, now I really want to become a samurai. So, that's probably going to be the first thing we're probably going to be doing. Is we're going to be becoming a samurai. And then we're going to be focusing on the main story. And all that good stuff. But, yeah. So, anyways. Alright, so new few days done. Alright, let's see what... this one's going to be short. Because, look how late I am. And it's almost time for this. So anyway. Alright. Master Liger Kiryu. Master Liger Kiryu. You have come to the most excellent time. An invitation from a truly parchment personage was delivered in the manor but a short while ago. Would that you would be present to receive it. But in any event, Sir Emek de Borel, Lord Speaker of the House of Lords, Lord Commander of the Temple Knights, Vice Count of House Borel, cordially invites Master Legacity to dine with him at, in his estate. Hey! Oh, isn't it? Wait, is this the date that everybody's been saying about Sir Aymeric? I'm you seem surprised. The messenger assured me that his lord has brochured the subject with you an earlier date, when the arrangements for the past conference were still being finalized. Of course, the invitation moons afford little opportunity for the leisure, but with that happy advent of peace, 'tis plain that the Lord Commander sees no further cause to delay. What do you think? I would gladly accept it. I would, but I haven't the foggiest idea what to wear. Any thoughts? To be honest, I'd rather not. Oh, we could flat out reject it. And you know what? Listen. From what I'm told, this is like something that people have been thirsting over Aymeric, and that this is like essentially like a date for them. And for me, it's just like dinner with a buddy, dinner with a close friend. But anyway, to each their own, right? To each their own. You can perceive it all that you want. But let's face it, Sir Aymeric's heart belongs to Lucia, and Lucia's heart belongs to Sir Aymeric. Come on, you'd be a blind idiot not to see that. Anyways, indeed, who would not want, who would not? You will forgive me if I am envious. Wow, literally everybody's thirsting over Sir Aymeric. Anyways. Thou shalt send word of the acceptance to Burrell Manor at once. When you are ready, pray report to the I cannot read. I'm illiterate. It will have some escort for you the rest of the way. Okay. All right. What are all these guys? Anyway. There we go. Oop. Alright, where is he at? Ah, there we go. Greetings, well met, Master Legacity. I have an honor and privilege to serve the head board of the House Burrell. So admittedly, our staff is somewhat smaller than those of the noble family. Being countable is on one hand. And my lord will be overjoyed to hear that you have accepted the invitation. As you will soon see, you have spared no expense. I dare say a man of such actions as yourself near a moment of respite in the battlefield. Beckon, I am sure, but this is the day I bid you lay down your burdens and raise a glass of peace and prosperity. Alright then. Okay, now I see why people say this is like a date. Bruh.
To think the Moogles would prove such harsh taskmasters. Forgive me. I did not know you had suffered so in your quest for the horn.
Bruh.
I must say, your spirited accounts always come as a welcome change from the arid reports which fill my days.
That sure is. Hey! Oh, wine? No, thank you. I don't drink. I can see why people are thirsting after this. Oh, man. Oh, God. Please don't be... I'm getting PTSD from Nanamo. Oh, Nanamo. I'm concerned.
Though I have lived in these lands my entire life, to hear you speak of them, there is much and more I have yet to see. Truly, yours was a marvelous journey.
It was. Though perhaps it's a bit long for my liking. Why not join me in the next time? It wasn't all sunshine and lemon cakes. Alright. Let's invite him. Why don't you join me next time?
Well, truth be told, when I think back on the sweeping vistas of the churning mists, I do feel some slight pangs of wanderlust. Alas, much as I would like to accept your invitation, I fear my present duties with the House of Lords demand my undivided attention. Someday, perhaps.
Someday, hopefully.
By your deeds, you have helped us to lay the foundation for lasting reform.
True.
The formation of the Republic is but the beginning. For it is not only our system of governance which must needs change. We, the people, must learn to let go of our hatreds and rise above our bloody past.
Damn straight.
I only pray that I live long enough to see us achieve some measure of success. That I might know the lost did not die in vain.
Amen.
I can still see you there on the steps of faith, striding fearlessly towards the worm. If you could do
that, badass.
Who are we to balk at the challenges ahead?
Right? That's still a badass moment. The Warrior of Light walking towards the danger while everybody else is running away from it. Man, that's iconic.
The question of how best to strengthen ties with the other great nations of Eorzea has been debated at length in the Lords and Commons of late. As you may imagine, maintaining stability during this period of historic upheaval is our paramount concern. Nevertheless, we are greatly indebted to the Alliance for their support during the Grand Melee, and it would be remiss of us not to repay their faith in kind. Of course, we owe you the greatest debt of all. And it is my hope that in extending our support to you and the Scions, we might also express our gratitude to our neighbors, nay, our fellow Eorzeans, whom we pray you will continue to protect.
I protect everyone, dude. I know I can't protect everyone, but I'll protect everyone that I can.
The Lords and Commons agree on very little. But not a soul in either house begrudges your order this offer of patronage. For all you have done and will do, we thank you.
Oh God. Oh God, please no. I'm getting serious PTSD. Please, nobody have poisoned this. Please, for the love of God, nobody have poisoned the... Oh, thank God.
May I ask a personal question?
All right, ask.
Now that the dust has settled, what will you do? Not as a Scion, I mean, but... What do you want for yourself?
I never really put much thought into that.
Lord Commander, pray forgive the interruption.
Oh.
News from House Volton.
An urgent message for the Warrior of Light. I was instructed to deliver it without delay.
Oh, shoot.
Master Thancred returned to the manor a short time ago, bearing an injured maiden.
Oh, shoot.
Master Leveilleur and Mistress Tataru are tending to her wounds, but they like not her chances. Respectfully, my lord, they have requested the Warrior of Light's immediate presence.
Oh, shoot. All right, duty call.
You must go to them, my friend, and I shall go with you.
Oh, bro. Okay, I can see why people are so... Well, most people got mad at this. She basically cocked
for
you,
every
depending on how
ending
you feel about this.
Marks a new beginning.
Alright. Time to get ready for Stormblood.
From tragedy and sacrifice, we rise to greet a new dawn. As did he. Only to be drawn unto another battlefield, another cause, as if by fate.
Mm-hmm. All right. Objective complete. Hey. Fortemp Manor. Alright, where is she?
Yes.
Is that... Alize, Alphino's twin sister.
Yep.
She ran afoul of the Warriors of Darkness. I had been tracking them since the ceremony at Falcon's Nest. Little did I know I was not the only one. Evidently, she had learned of their activities and attempted to shadow them on her own. Poorly. I rescued her in the Twelves Wood, and together we fled north. But though I made every effort to cover our tracks, they caught up with us on the Ishgardian border. And in the ensuing struggle, Alize took an arrow to the shoulder. It was only after we had made good our escape that I realized it was poisoned.
Oh, shit.
Thank you for coming so quickly. And you, Sir Emmerich.
Think nothing of it. How is she?
We have done all we can for now. Although the immediate danger has passed, the poison yet lingers in her blood. We came to Eorzea together, hoping to bring salvation to the realm our grandfather gave his life to protect. But when confronted with the bitter realities of its politics and its petty powermongers, she was driven to anger and to doubt. She refused to become embroiled in what she termed Eorzea's squabbles and distance herself from the Scions. Though she remained hopeful of a brighter future, she would walk her own path. Would that it had not been so perilous. For all our differences, she's as dedicated as any Scion to the salvation of Eorzea. But more than that, she is my sister. To be reunited with her, only to lose her forever! Gods, even to speak the words.
Take heart, Master Alphino. She will be attended by our most skilled Kyrugians. Bear Mistress Leveilleur to the infirmary at once. Apprise Captain Whitecape of the situation, and inform him that she is to be treated as my personal charge.
Wait, don't go. Please, come closer.
Oh, shoot.
warriors of darkness are in league with the Ascians. Slaughtering the primals is but the first step in their plan.
Oh.
They make for Zelvatol to bring about Garuda's summoning and to kill her. You must stop them.
Well, you heard the lady.
I shall inform the others at once.
Master Thancred, I would ask that you accompany Mistress Levea to the infirmary. Your knowledge of her injuries may well prove useful in determining her treatment.
Of course.
Well, shoot. All right. Surely they won't let her. Yes, I know we must in Captain White and the Turrogans. Did they not bring Athenian back from the very brink of death? I'm uncomfortably reminded of how he mocked me for praying at his bedside for days on end. What do you think, my friend? Shall we turn our attention to the matter of whose conclusion we have yet to be in the power of influence? Take that. Thank you very much. Alrighty then. Well, considering it's almost time for me to get ready for work, this is probably going to be the last mission. So, man, I should have really timed this properly. So the Warriors of Darkness and the Ascians are trying to bring about Garuda's summoning, and they might put her to the sword. Then when we first encountered them both in Lost Gant, they were confronting Ravana. God, has that been their aim all along? What do you intend to do, Master Elfinote? There is much more I do not understand, but I know this is a primal summoning, cannot be ignored. Azrael, Alisal risked her life to uncover this plot. In the squander her gift of Feral Rex, will you accompany me to the fight, Zelvatol, and help me with the Zaxxel ritual? Alright. You and the Ishgardians share a border with the Zaxxel homeland. We have but a vested interest in the outcome of this ritual. Yeah, but willing to suffer a beastman's intrusions in Corrin's lands to a point, but summoning of a primal is the escalation we cannot abide. You shall have the fastest airship, Master Fano. The mountains of the Zaxxel are not easily traversed, and the endeavor demands all haste. Gesture most appreciated, Ceramic, but I fear the aerial approach is destined to fail. This is their homeland, and all the Zaxxel celebrants are not to be underestimated. No experience tells me none to conceivable approach by the land. I believe it would be wiser to choose the cross into the Zaxxel by the way of mountain pass, east of the dragon camp. In that case, I shall send instructions for a contingent of the camp knights to place at your disposal. They will secure a safe passage through the mountains and escort you to the Zaxxel. Though my men are unqualified to control a primal, they are more than capable of contending with the Zaxxel. We should be glad of their assistance, Lord Edmund. In the event of Mistress Alisal regains consciousness, we will share you with the additional information that she may provide. May the Fury watch over you and keep you safe. Let's be off then. We should procure an additional supply of required in Camp Dragonhead. Alrighty then, back to Camp Dragonhead. Damn, it's been... How long has it been? Alright, my gear's all perfect. Let's do it, I forgot to. Alrighty then. Alright, Alpha now. Have you everything you require? Excellent. The entrance is a path north of east of Dragonhead. Though it's normally guarded by a score of Zacta warriors, it's been informed that Al Sportsman's knights have already dispatched with them. The enemy's gates lie open. Let's walk through it. Alrighty then. Hey, how you doing? Alrighty then. Alrighty then. Master Lagakir, Master Elfenod, as you can see, the gate is ours. I'd advise that our scouts be recounting increased activity around the first mountain. Simply put, they are up to something and we don't know not to interfere. We stand ready in the escort. Given the numbers likely to encounter, okay. While the knights are a large force, the Zacta pay attention. Suggest that you make attempts to slip past their defenses and locate the site of summoning ritual. If the gods are good, you should have only to deal with a few patrols, but if they're not, you may be forced to battle with the Warriors of Darkness. Alrighty then. Alright. We just gotta sit here and wait. Ready then? You know what? Could use some target practice. God damn. Okay, it might be too overpowered. I literally do need to leave too. And I do not want to end the stream without doing the dungeon. Without having some excitement for the continuation of the story. Ooh, come on. Come on, please show up. Pretty pretty with a cherry top? I have no idea how long this is gonna take. If it gets to 6:30, I'm probably gonna end the stream because I can't I can't sit around wasting your time, especially when I need to get ready. And all that. Is there anything else we can do while in the meantime? Oh wow, okay. Okay, perfect. 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 They came in the perfect time. Oh shoot, I forgot to put my tank stands on. Somebody's in the Christmas spirit. Alright, there we go. Oh! I don't know, I don't have projectiles like I do with the Dark Knight. Alrighty. Oh boy, this is gonna be a long one. Alrighty then. Oh, missed that. Alright, boss battle time. What the hell? shit. We got blown the F up. The loot we got. We got it. We got this, right? Oh shit, oh come on, are you? Let me go in front. I'm gonna distract them. This is my raw attack. I distract them. You guys take them out. Perfect. Oh, shoot, another boss battle. Oh. We need... Alright, two more objectives to go. Oh, yo. I didn't even realize that. Holy shit, this guy's been definitely roaring out for sure. Oh shit, Garuda! Are you kidding me? We have to pay the bubble too? go. Alright. Oh, perfect time. It's already 6:30. Alrighty then. Path. Okay. Alrighty then. Alright, helmet off for the rest of the story. Alright, we're gonna end the stream here. Ooh, 51 minutes. Eh, not bad.
Thank the gods! What happened?
Crazy shit has happened. Garuda showed up.
So they were unable to see the ritual to its completion. Then Garuda is no longer a threat, and whatever the Asians and the Warriors of Darkness were planning has come to naught. But we should not tarry. The knights have secured our path to safety.
Well, well. What do we have here?
You'd better not have killed the primal without us.
Now we wouldn't, you old goat.
You!
Wait, I know you. Still walking, I see. I could have sworn my name was true.
Man, Alphino taking L's left and right.
Just what is your game? Leading us the long way so these fools could step in and claim our prize?
No, now, let's not make hasty accusations. By the look of things, the ritual was proceeding as planned. We arrived at the appointed hour. Twas they who erred.
It is hopeless. We cannot face them all.
Do mine ears deceive? A boy! So that's the way of it. Twins! You had me worried for a moment there. Know that I will happily make it quicker for you, if you just stand still.
Enough, Jarumul.
Wait.
We wouldn't want to upset the man in white with any unnecessary bloodshed now, would we?
Wait, is that...
You've been awfully busy since we were kind enough to spare your lives.
Kind enough? You guys got lucky Thancred was there to stop me.
While you were idly consorting with the Asians, you mean? Seven hells! What could you possibly hope to achieve?
Should I explain it to you? Very well. Consider it a reward of sorts for beating us here. You know the tale of Hydaelyn and Zodiac, I take it. Of the great sundering and the reflections it created.
Across 10 and 3 they were divided. Reflections of the source, each possessed of shards of light and dark.
Just so. One of those reflections, the one nearest to the source, is our home. And we were the heroes blessed with her light.
Oh.
But not all worlds hold light and dark in equal measure. In ours, the power of light was greater by far. So the Asians, who once threatened our home, were no match. And they fell before us, one after another, till none were left. Victory, we thought. And then then came the light. A flood of pure, blinding radiance, annihilating shadow and color and life itself. Ere long, it will consume our world, leaving naught in its wake but blank perfection.
That cannot be. Do you honestly expect us to believe such a story?
Believe what you like. But it has happened before, on a world far removed from ours. The 13th, which was swallowed by the dark and transformed into what you call the void. Unchallenged light would condemn us to a similar fate. And so we joined hands with our former enemies, and with their aid came here, to the source. For there is but one way to restore the balance and save our home. The Ardor. Calamitous destruction with the power to break down the barriers between planes and see our worlds rejoined.
Oh. You would doom our world to save your own? What would even become of us? Of you?
Enough. I tire of talking. You know our cause. You know what is at stake. We are prepared to do whatever it takes. Are you?
If there is aught you would say, say it. Otherwise, begone. You have no friends here.
Is that who I thought it was? I mean, was that you, Anjay? We did see him with them earlier. Oh, Lord, what are you up to? All things considered, we should be grateful we have survived that encounter. Do you think it could be true that to save their world, they must bring ruin to ours? No. It matters not which war-torn destruction is beyond justification. Whatever the reasoning, they must be stopped. The sacrifice, the loss, it ends here. Alrighty then. Well, I guess that makes sense that both our worlds are two sides of the same coin. Hopefully this transports us to a different location. Forgive me, but it's neither the time or the place for idle inscription. The knights are aspiring at Lord Edmund's success. And Lord Commander, more importantly, I should like to see my sister's condition has improved. That may take a moment to yourself as you wish. I will be at the congregation. Alrighty then. Oh yeah, I also forgot to mention my Cho-Cho. Look at him. Look how adorable. Look how adorable he looks. Alright, anyway. Alright, the foundation. Perfect. We can head over there right now. So that's actually interesting, considering the Warriors of Darkness are literally based on the actual Warrior of Light. That's like the cover character of the game itself. Which is wild to think about. So essentially, they're like a mirror universe to what we perceive to be our universe. That's interesting. Oh man, this game gets more interesting the more and more time I play it. But yeah. Anyways, oh damn. All right. Anyways, that's where I'm gonna call it a day because I gotta get ready for work. So anyways, tomorrow, hopefully. Oh my god, I've been saying this for too long. Hopefully. I wake up at the right time. Yeah, but anyways, Yeah, you can follow me on my socials. My Twitter handle is at LegoKiryu_Rex. My VOD channel on YouTube is Rex LegoKiryu VOD. That's a capital VOD and a lowercase F. Thank you for coming to my stream, and I hope to see you again real soon. Bye!